Sup, people? King of the Dead here, and horrible news. A storm came through and absolutely wiped my PC. I actually had to reset it from scratch. All my audio files, everything I was working on, everything's gone, and I don't want to talk about it. So right now I got Asente, Jinsui, Cruel Joid, and Leo the Madman back, and looky there, Invincible's back. It somehow beat the allegations of the hype dying off and came back with a fucking wild new episode. We'll talk about it. All right, as far as first impression, boys, what do y'all think?
I'm going to commit suicide.
It was for how long we waited, it was actually pretty good.
I do believe, as far as just coming back into it, I appreciate that, like, we do see how they took their time for their last goodbye to the Thaxons or Thraxons or whatever the fuck they are. Man, this race ages so quickly. I do appreciate that, like, she says her piece, and we respect, like, it makes sense. This is why I want Oliver to go with you. Oliver, the baby boy, who is going to turn into the worst little shit on planet Earth the second he learns how to talk. Man, so I'm going to assume the anime will do it better, but as far as comics goes, I hate Oliver up until he's a fully grown man. Fully grown man Oliver is cool. Everything beforehand, I hate Oliver so much.
Fair, he's a kid. I wouldn't blame you.
I know absolutely nothing about this baby. I just see a purple baby from a man who fucked a bug.
Bro, that bug was fine. Don't act like you wouldn't fuck that bug.
Did he put it in your thorax hole? How'd he do it?
Irrelevant.
No.
It doesn't matter.
I don't want to know how.
I want to watch it happen.
Sick for wanting to do
me
it.
Too.
I don't just want to watch. I want to be a part of it. Let me join in next time.
Let me join. Oh,
and God. This is the type of time.
All of you go straight to jail.
All right. Invincible gets back to Earth. And I do not understand why they're having him so committed to school. I really don't get what we're doing here. Even right now, his career path is just hero. I'm just a hero. This is the time frame where you would be a full-time hero. What exactly are you in school for? Why are they pushing it? It's like, Mark, you're not dropping out of college. For what? What was major be? Economics? What the fuck are we doing here?
To show that education is important, and if you don't buy a college education, we'll lose money.
They are not doing this for college propaganda. I refuse.
Also, I just realized something. What they can literally just do is, you know, normal kids also, you know, just go get a job. You can work for the government. You know, the government that's telling you to go save people.
My thing is that, you know, comics-wise, he doesn't really get a job or anything. He doesn't really need it. He doesn't really have an identity past a person on Earth. Nobody who knows him doesn't already know he's invincible. So, like, what would be the point?
Well, the job is just strictly for the fact of you need a cover-up for a normal life. You work for the government. That's the
easiest
cover-up you can potentially do.
But that's my point. Cover it up from who?
To get the classes.
My point is that cover it up from who? Who are you trying to hide this from? Like, they say Peter Parker is like, oh, I have to hide my identity to protect my loved ones. Because you do have the Mary Jane and the Aunt May. But in this situation, the government's looking out for Aunt May. And your Mary Jane is like, well, I guess the part of it is that he does still have that Amber. By now, he should have been broken up with Amber and been, like, starting shit with Eve. I guess, like, yeah, you have a human girlfriend. I just don't see, like, you can get around the world in 10 seconds. What threat are you trying to hide from?
Well, I don't think it's really, the way I'm looking at it is not them really trying to do a threat per se, but it's more like, okay, I take that back. You're actually right. Because if everybody was just minding their own business, it doesn't really matter what he does for a living now, does it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, fair point.
Let me just say, I've really noticed the Amber turnaround in this episode specifically.
Oh,
when he gets back from 2 months and she's just like, yeah, no, it's cool.
Calm before the storm. I can tell you right now, she will be either cheating on him or leaving him because he's still a flyboy. Like, he just got back. And then the next morning? It's all right, kid, head to space.
Mm-hmm. Yep. What did she call him? It's already obvious that she cannot handle having a superhero boyfriend, so why not just give it up?
This is not even his first, longest, or last trip to space. He will be gone for longer periods of time than this on the regular.
So in the comics, he's supposed to get with Eve, right?
Oh, it's gotta happen eventually. They're gonna break up. We just don't know how
or
when.
You can tell from this latest episode, I think she tried to call Mark. He didn't pick up and immediately called her friend saying, hey, y'all doing anything today?
It's not that he didn't pick up, it's that he let her know, like, hey, I just got back, I'm going to space again. See ya, you know, whenever. She's up, all right. He's been back for 7 hours. Let's get back in space.
bro.
So yeah, like it's just a matter of she know you like at this point you know you can't handle it. So you know what you do?
Mm-hmm.
Leave. Just leave. You know you can't handle being with a superhero.
All right, yeah. And before we get to the slaughter, I do want to take a minute. Rex as a character in the comics does not get that much play after what's her name? Duplicate leaves him for Immortal. He's just sort of kind of a quiet character. And then he just, every now and then once he opens his mouth, it's not to say douchebag shit anymore. It's just a vote of confidence up until the end. But, and also he never takes his mask off. So I love what they're doing with this Rex. I love that we're actually seeing the growth. They're not just saying he's grown. They're actually seeing, and I love that he takes his mask off more. He's a character that ever since Robot takes his body, Robot never puts the mask on. So they sort of use whatever this design is on Robot. But y'all can have Rex with the hair out. Time to time, please. I appreciate that the anime is doing that more. All right, we rambled enough. It's time. The Lizard League whooped their fucking asses.
Mm-hmm. God damn. I knew that as soon as Duplicate got crushed, I'm like, okay, so at least either Rex is gonna get killed or the small one. And then when he ate her, and then Rex is like, she doesn't stay small. And she started to grow, but then he like fucking crushed her back down.
Personally, a first.
Like, what the fuck?
I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm looking at that scene of just like, how is this even physically possible?
The man was flexing from the inside.
Yes. He was flexing. How do you flex your insides?
What kind of weights do you be hitting?
Is you are flexing the exterior. Like, what do you do? Like, what did you do? Just basically cut, like, what is it? Hit like a, the equivalent of like a curl. You folded your body inward.
The most muscular.
And then that,
see,
so what?
It's a pose called the most muscular, where you like sort of what he did. You like flex, like you bring your arms down, basically show like your biceps and your lats and shit.
Yeah. So is that basically what he did? Because also by that, no. This is also the other thing. Okay, you did that with your muscles. She was in there with your heart, kidney, stomach, all this other stuff.
Well, he said yum, so I think she was still in his esophagus.
She was still in his throat.
And they're supposed to be like
even still
snake people, right? I thought he was like flexing the fact that he's like a snake, mostly muscle.
They're all some kind of snake. That's the Lizard League's thing.
Yeah, that's the whole thing. So it makes sense, kind of. I guess that's just his power to just be muscular.
My thing is that, so you can't, and like, okay, if the implication is that he's just as tough on the inside as he is out, he sure was eating those explosions, but not the one that was inside of him.
That's true.
That shit popped him like a fucking grape.
He didn't have time to, he got, was it three or four? I didn't see how many fingers he bit off, but he got
his hand.
He got almost his whole fucking hand
before he
died.
It's not almost.
Dude, are you?
It's his entire hand.
Down to the wrist.
He saw was a nub.
Damn.
He was, at that point, he was just another. He was crippled. He was crippled.
He's like half. He's half you. He's half. He's lost all of his power because Rex Bolt's whole thing is that from his fingertips, he can like charge shit up with thermal energy. So he just lost a hand.
That's, oh my god, they really gave him the My Hero Academy treatment.
The overhaul. Like, well, worthless now. Yeah.
Can't they just regrow it in a lab?
No, it's a superpower. They can't regrow that shit.
Okay. Man, bump it. Just make it with the left. Your right one just makes explosive for the left. You just shoot them. Just launch them.
And duplicate, sweetheart. The one with the number one on her chest should never leave the cave.
I agree.
Unless you're saying that only the original Kate can make clones, and we know that's not true. So why were you even, when they broke up and started fighting teams and shit, why did Kate get the Hulk? Her whole thing, that is just a lot of her. Like, why would, I don't know.
Okay. Strength in numbers.
The real thing is that they should have just held their L. Like, neither Kate nor Shrinking Ray really were the optimal fight for that.
I'm saying, like, fact, who was, though?
Because why did they take Black Samson? Someone else should have stayed behind.
They had no muscle on Earth. You got Blast Team explode, shrinks a lot, and look, there's more. That's the team. We lost two bays in one go. The only bays left on the team. Eve, underaged, and gone. Monster Girl, Lolly, a real Lolly, bro. The only two bays we had to work with, dead on the floor. Well, dead. One's dead on the floor, and one is dead in a body. You know they say you shit yourself when you die. Maybe she's on the in that man's spandex, caught between some shit and spandex right now.
Are we getting close to the Alan part?
Yeah, go ahead.
God damn, I knew he was gonna get big. But he fucking accidentally broke the machine. I fucking love
that. Am I crazy, or is he not that much bigger, perspectively, than he was before?
He's not, but it's still noticeable.
He was more like a... How about put this? Before he went into the machine, he was like Baki, right? Muscular, but very... You can see he was skinny.
Slim fit?
Yeah, slim fit. When he came out, he looked more like Broly.
No, he was not that big.
Well, no, I'm talking about size comparisons, right? So, like...
Mean like Super first form Broly, yeah, as compared to Super... Oh, okay, when you put it like
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
All right, so I can get behind
like,
that.
More like Super Broly to old school Broly. That's probably more like it.
I can wrap my head around that.
I could see that. Yeah, I could see that.
Also, they didn't really explain what that was. When the dude, Thaddeus, who's voiced by Peter Cullen, who does Optimus Prime, does the thing... He's all like, I never want to see another Viltrumite again. He does what's called the Viltrumite, what's it called? Mustache trial, which means rip off your beard. It just means rip off your beard. It's just a ritual that says prove you're a Viltrumite. And he does it. He rips off the beard and the mustache stays. And he's like, you're a Viltrumite? Is that really all it fucking takes? Look, I have a mustache. Evil! Like, what?
Evil. Rips off beard.
No. The dude just has a mustache, and like I understand, like, whoa, what'd you do that for? Because in the comics, I talk about the comics a lot in these reviews. I gotta stop. But in the comics, he rips it off while explaining that he's one of the oldest Viltrumites. That man's like tens of thousands years old. But in this one, he literally just rips it off, and Alan's like, "You're one of them. How did you know?" This is the same man who didn't know that Nolan was a Viltrumite, by the way. So how did you piece that one together?
Actually, fair point. I was about to defend him, but you got a point now.
What the fuck?
Because I was going to say, if you have them looking at him, so I guess they do got a similar facial structure. But then you just hit me with that.
One of them looks like Steve Harvey. Like, all the fucking Viltrumites don't look alike.
No, they don't look alike, but you know they can have a resemblance.
Yeah, fair enough.
For their race.
All right, all the thing I got left to say is, all hail the Lizard League, bro. God damn. All right, anything else from y'all?
Oh, in this universe, if I had superpowers and I was a hero, Lizard League, I don't care who you are. Villain? Oh, you trying to mess stuff up? Oh, man, we got to take him to prison.
Fuck that. Kill him.
What do you mean prison? They're 6 feet in the ground right
now. I'm saying it was always like, oh, it's the Lizard League. Yeah, I got to go deal with the Lizard League. Just like, you know, Villain of the Week. And then it's not even they did anything special. It's just they just fucking locked in. It's all right, now let's get for real, boys. And just started the massacre.
It's not even that they locked in. No, I take it back. No, we'll use that. They locked in. They said, this was just convenience, but the moment everybody that would mess them up record time left, they just so happened to also pop up and do their thing. I would also like to say this one thing. Rex, this is also 100% your fault because who throws a red flag like that immediately after the All-Stars leave?
There's no way we're going to have two World Universal threats in one go. Nigga.
The worst part is the second one wasn't even universal.
I'm saying, had like, the CJ's talking shit about Black Samson. Black Samson could have handled that shit.
But hey, you could have left bulletproof. Just leave one of them.
I would have Black Samson there instead of where he belonged. Which was with them, dang it.
With the weaklings. You're the strongest weaklings. Of the weaklings, not the weakest of the strongest. You got it mixed up.
Yeah, really, bro.
But this is also the other thing. Your major people left. We are stuck with the bottom of the barrel. You're not going to call for help to be like, hey, we need at least one of your
my nigga,
people.
My nigga, it's the Lizard League.
Solo.
It's the Lizard League. They didn't know it'd be like this.
It's the Lizard League.
They basically just said, hey, bottom tier Justice League members, go handle the fucking Gangrene Gang from Powerpuff Girls. Just should have been easy.
No,
but
realistically,
also,